welcome to The Invite. My name is Betty Kyalo. Well, it is in this show that we will make you talk, think, laugh, cry, and sometimes want to pull your hair on issues that affect us on a day-to-day. Well, I'm ready to steer different conversations forward, conversations that will inspire you and motivate you, among other things, like getting you mad, excited, happy. So sit back as tonight we tell it all on The Invite. Well, today we start with something that made headlines for a couple of days. Well, remember this guy? Of course you do. If not, he is the newly appointed CBK governor, who is 54 years but not married. Well, according to him, he is okay being a senior bachelor, or what I've come to realize is also called an antique bachelor, following his religious practices. But the question we are asking tonight is, why is it such a big deal that he is not married at the age of 54? Is it wrong to be an antique bachelor, so to speak, or a spinster? Also on the show, we have a special segment, first time ever on Kenyan television. Well, we are calling it Babies and Moms. And today, we are taking our expectant mothers on a beautiful journey. You do not want to miss that. But let's begin with this very, very interesting collection of opinions from Kenyans on our topic of discussion.
Si lazima mtu aoe. Inategemea na uamuzi ya mtu. Ukiona anaweza kuoa, anaweza kuoa.
Wakati umechelewa kuoa, kwa mfano mtu wa 54 years, ukianza mtoto wa baby class ndio wewe unaenda kuretire miaka 60, hata tukupe 70, huyu mtoto zinamuumiza, hata kama utasave.
Being single, it is not a sin. A man does not want to get married, he should not be questioned. We should live life to the fullest and the way each one of us want to live.
Mtu aweze akalazimishwa wakati wa kuoa, maana kuoa inabidi tu kulingana na uwezo wa mtu.
Marriage is a choice. It should not be something that a man is forced to do because he has attained a certain age. So if he chooses to be a bachelor but he can perform on his duties, then I don't find a problem.
Tuseme tu kuanzia 35 kurudi mpaka 20, mwanaume mzuri inafaa hapo uwe na mke, lakini unapopita 35 kuendelea, kwa hakika mali pale hautakuwa unaenda vizuri.
Si vizuri mtu akae kajaoa, kwa sababu saa unaona miaka inaenda, maisha yake ina, unaona nataka kuoa kama akona miaka 60, hivi atachelewa mpaka kulea.
Let me begin by introducing my very diverse and very interesting guest. I'll start with Tony Kiama, who is a pastor. Thank you very much for joining us.
Thank you.
And the very most important and very interesting person in this conversation, John Lorenzo Bishop. He's the guy who says, you know what, I'm not ready to get married, and I probably won't be ready to get married in a very, very long time. Is that right?
Absolutely. Yes.
I hope by the time we finish this conversation, your perspective will have changed.
I don't think so.
And let me introduce a lovely lady, Esther Kiama, who is a counselor, also a psychologist and motivational speaker. Thank you very much for joining us.
Thank you.
All right, so we've painted the picture. There's a lot of hullabaloo about the CBK governor now being 54 and not married. First of all, I'd like to just hear your comment on that. I'll start with you, Pastor Kiama.
All right, I think number one, his position as the governor of this country, his being married is neither here nor there. Mm-hmm. He's qualified, he's worked in IMF, mm-hmm. and I think the greater issue would be how he has been trained or cultured because of how IMF has handled its business, mm-hmm. and how that will influence how he runs our nation. Mm-hmm. But I also want to say that in scripture, in the book of Timothy, the Bible says that the qualifications of a leader is that he should be able to manage his family well. Mm-hmm. And I want to say that the position of a governor is not necessarily to count our money or to tell us how much we're worth, but actually to tell us how much we're worth. But it's at that level, it's basically policy. Mm-hmm. And these policies affect us as a nation and eventually as a family. Mm-hmm. And I want to say that for me, I would be a bit skeptical in the sense that I'd want to know, how does he know how it hurts and he's never really experienced it.
Okay.
And so I guess in that sense, I would want to have had someone who has a family, though we have so many of them in positions
in parliament.
Of leadership,
yeah.
Who are a sham.
Exactly.
To the office they represent.
All right, interesting view there. Esther, I'd like to hear your view on this. Is it a big deal that, you know, he's 54 and not married and is not actually hoping to get married anytime soon?
Well, I think that's a choice.
Mm-hmm.
And life is full of choices. And he knows the reason. But I think if he can be very honest, a time comes when he's lonely. By the way, I looked at him. He looks a happy man,
mm-hmm.
So I think he's happy with his choice.
Mm-hmm.
And I think even most of those who are saying they are married, most of them are psychologically divorced,
mm-hmm.
and okay. So psychologically single.
Mm-hmm. But let me bring in what Pastor Kiama has just said about, you know, even the Bible talking about a leader, you know, and them being able to, first of all, you know, have that basic... family, you know, family values. Well, what do you say about that?
Well, it's good for a leader to have a wife,
mm-hmm.
because even the same Bible says whoever gets a wife gets a good thing.
Okay.
And I wished he just tasted and felt that good thing.
Okay.
Because I see married men happy, and I see them sharing with their wives,
mm-hmm.
those who are genuinely married,
mm-hmm.
And I think as a leader, it's good to have a helper. Because when you go back to the Bible, in creation, God said, let us make a man in our image.
Mm-hmm.
Then when God looked at the same man, he looked lonely. And God said, let us make him a helper.
All right. Lorenzo, the fact that he is not married, and we'll be expanding this conversation in a short while, but the fact that he is not married, do you think that that makes him less of a leader? That makes it very hard for him to understand issues, you know, to do with, you know, people, families. Do you think that should put him in that position?
To me, as Lorenzo, the CBK governor, Dr. Patrick Ngugi, is the best man for the job.
Mm-hmm.
Now, basically, his marital status has nothing to do with the work.
Mm-hmm.
But the fact that he's not married gives him even more advantage. This is a man who is going to dedicate
mm-hmm.
his time and all resources to serving his country.
Mm-hmm.
If he were married, then you'd be disturbed at times when you're working. Both of us have jobs, all of us here.
Mm-hmm.
And at times you need to work till certain hours.
Mm-hmm.
If you're married, someone will be waiting for you at home. But this is a guy who's single.
Do you think he's in touch? Do you think him being not married, he's in touch with the issues that face people, you know, young people, children, families, mums, dads? Do you think he's in touch with these issues?
Absolutely.
Because he has, probably he just has himself to think about and maybe his work. Do you think that he has time for any other person apart from himself and what he does?
No, if you insinuate that the fact that he's not married
mm-hmm.
makes him not in touch,
mm-hmm.
not to be in touch, that's a lie. This is a man who has siblings, okay?
Mm-hmm.
He has brothers. He also belongs to a certain community. There are people around him. The fact that he doesn't have kids of his own does not make him irresponsible.
Mm-hmm.
He's a responsible man. He can relate to every single challenge that all of us go through. And perhaps he can even do it better without bias.
Okay, so I want to expand this conversation a little bit. And Lorenzo, I'm still on you. You are a guy and you're a bachelor, and actually I've gotten the word antique bachelor. I've been speaking to so many bachelors, and some of them call themselves antiques or classics. You know, they don't ever want to get married. Are you that kind of a person? You never want to get married?
First, let's understand that where I come from,
mm-hmm.
my school of thought, is that ideal women for marriages died with my mother. My mother is still alive, but that generation.
It's no longer here.
The current crop of women or ladies, with due respect to them, do not fit the bill. I want to live my life this way. There's nothing. I've not stolen from anyone.
Uh-huh.
I'm living my life. I'm just having my time. You know, Betty, you must understand that what do people look for in marriage?
Mm-hmm.
They're looking for companionship,
mm-hmm.
looking for someone to start a family, You're looking for living happily ever after.
Yeah.
How many people do you know who are living happily?
Well, that's relative. That's relative. Pastor Kiam, I want to bring in to bring you in this, you know, conversation. He says that, you know, there are no longer women who are eligible or women who fit the bill. Do you think it's the case?
I think that because the issue here is, it's important for you to remember that a lot has changed,
yes,
even in terms of cultures. And culture evolves. The way people lived 100 years ago is not the way they live today. Values tend to, you know, shift.
Mm-hmm.
But I want to say this. For me, when I look at the governor, there is something that you see in a man who's married.
Mm-hmm.
There is stability.
Mm-hmm.
Because your wife will be talking to you. You'll be getting positive or negative feedback from somebody who, you know, is close to you, who will be honest.
Mm-hmm.
And I want to say this. There are marriages that are working, but there are also many other marriages that are not.
Mm-hmm.
And the question for me is, why focus on the ones that are not? Why don't you focus on the ones that are?
Okay.
Because marriage is actually a great institution. That wasn't even man's idea. That was God's idea, the God who created all of us.
Mm-hmm.
And I want to say this, that marriage is not a prerequisite for life or for going to heaven.
Mm-hmm.
So it's a personal choice that you choose. But I also want to say this, that if you declare that you're a bachelor, then we shouldn't see you on the streets, perambulating all over the place with other women.
Okay.
Usumame na ukauke. But don't be messing around with other chicks.
Uh-huh, uh-huh.
You understand what I'm saying?
Yes, you're a bachelor, but you also want to have, you know, the pluses, you know?
Exactly.
Different
without
women
commitment.
Without commitment.
So I want to say this, that number one, when you're married, it gives you credibility in society. And then, but and as much as your siblings or your cousins or your whoever will have children, it's different because the honors of bringing up these children is on me. And the Bible clearly says this in 1 Timothy chapter 3. It says that a man who is able to manage his family well. And I'm saying this, that if we were to look critically, even at the people who are in leadership today, and put that, you know, some of those guys will not qualify to be leaders because they have not manage their families well.
Mm-hmm.
And I want to say this, I think it's critical for us to look at that aspect. And I also want to say that when you choose not to, it's your personal choice, but that does not remove you from the eye of society to also watch on how you live.
Mm-hmm.
Because if you're going to be out there wasting other people's children,
mm-hmm, and time.
I think it's wrong.
And time.
Pastor, for Christ's sake, are we going to center this discussion on the Bible? Because, you know, I don't like the fact that you keep referring to the Bible, to the Bible, to the Bible. But my biggest problem with preachers many a time is selective reading and application of the Bible.
Then why don't
do you have any
why
other
don't you pick another
yes,
area
yes,
of the Bible?
There are so many people in the Bible,
mm-hmm,
who did their work and lived their life. They didn't get married. Apostle Paul?
Mm-hmm.
Was he married? Was St. Stephen married? Let us look at Bible in totality.
Mm-hmm.
There are people who make choices.
That's a theological question.
I didn't interrupt you. The fact that one person has made a decision,
mm-hmm,
not to get married, other people who are not part of his or her life have nothing to do with it. The way I'm going to lead my life has nothing to do with your ministry.
Esther, I'd like to hear your thoughts.
He has quoted Paul, and Paul has said, "If you will make it to the end,
mm-hmm,
it's okay, and if you won't, it's okay to get married."
Mm-hmm.
So he has a choice, but I also support the pastor,
mm-hmm,
that you don't need to say, "I will remain single."
Mm-hmm.
And every day there is a girl leaving your house in the morning,
exactly,
a different one,
mm-hmm,
meaning you are wasting their time and they are wasting them. So when somebody chooses and says, "I'll be a bachelor, a smart bachelor,"
mm-hmm,
let him stand as a bachelor and not waste other girls. Let them go to their people who would like to marry them.
Let's not mix issues,
mm-hmm,
here.
Mm-hmm.
There's being a bachelor.
So what are you?
Uh-huh.
So we're also looking for a moral
human
bachelor.
Yes.
So you see, the day you choose to seek public office,
right,
then your life becomes
a public life.
Mm-hmm.
Yes. And it is open for scrutiny.
Yes.
Because you're going to be managing one of the most critical institutions of this country. And we also want morality to come together and ethics to come together with that particular public office. So if you're not going to get married, then we don't expect you to be, you know, for lack of a better word, hanyaring all over the place.
Mm-hmm.
You have a public office. You are subject to us. You're managing our resources. And we want someone who is stable. Of course, now this is too late in the discussion, but he's already in office.
Mm-hmm.
But I want to say this, that it is important at this particular point for him to know that we are looking at him. He is going to be an example to many young men in society today.
Well, Pastor Kema, let me throw in something there. The CBK governor, he says that he's not married because of his religious practices. You know, he's decided that he's going to give that he does not want any other thing but to give his time.
I think he does.
Mm-hmm.
And as he said, it's a personal choice.
Mm-hmm.
No one can hold your hand and give you a wife and make you marry.
Mm-hmm.
But I want to say this, the fact that he's single, he's as qualified, and I'm sure the legislators did their work, and kudos to what they did, and this man is in office.
Mm-hmm.
He's qualified. But I want to say this, as a single bachelor, it is important for him to remember that we also expect morality
mm-hmm.
and ethical decisions in that particular office that pertain to making policy that will affect society, and society is made up of family.
Mm-hmm.
Yes. So when we're talking about rebates in tax rebates, in, you know, people who have families
mm-hmm.
or rental homes.